iPhone Mirroring is a new application release on iOS 18 and the latest macOS system, Sequoia. This video, I will show you how to use iPhone Mirroring after the update and how to solve problems encountered with iPhone Mirroring related issues. For example, it is not available in the EU. Hello, welcome to Tenorshare. First, you can go to Settings, then General, and tap on AirPlay and Continuity. There is a new setting called iPhone Mirroring, which allows you to use your iPhone on your nearby Mac. The next thing you need to do is turn on the passcode. Otherwise, you cannot connect to the Mac. Make sure your iPhone is charging and that both your iPhone and Mac are connected to the same Wi-Fi network. Also, ensure that Bluetooth is turned on and both devices are nearby. Now we can mirror the iPhone on the Mac. After the update, you will see the iPhone mirroring appeared in your launchpad automatically. Click Continue. When you use iPhone mirroring, you need to lock the iPhone. And now, you can use your iPhone on the Mac, even play mobile games. It must be recognized that there are still a few issues when using iPhone mirroring. For example, you cannot use it when your iPhone is in standby mode, or the phone can't connect to the computer. But what if you still want to experience this feature? Here, I recommend Tenorshare Phone Mirror. It helps you mirror phones to C's and Macs for free, so you can control your devices with your mouse and keyboard. Click on the link in the description area to download, install, and open Tenorshare Phone Mirror. After starting the program, click on iOS on the screen. Click on How to Screen Mirror iOS Device, and follow the three steps to mirror your iPhone or iPad to PC wirelessly. After the successfully connection in a few seconds, your iPhone screen will be displayed on the PC. You can also show full screen for a clearer view. If you are still interested in iPhone mirroring, the following methods can be used to try to solve the problem. First, you need to update your iPhone to iOS 18 and Mac to macOS Sequoia. After that, check that the Wi-Fi, Bluetooth, and Apple ID of both the computer and the phone are unified. If the problem persists, restart your phone and computer. It is now working fine. Okay, that's all for today. If you liked this video, please click subscribe, and we will keep updating the video about iOS 18. See you next time.